Thank you. Good evening. I would like to welcome you to the annual recognition reception. Tonight we will honor the graduating class and their families, student award winners, and new members of the Honor Society who will be inducted. First, I would like to introduce a few special guests. Please stand when I introduce you, and please hold your applause until all guests are introduced. School Board Chairman, Mrs. Nicole Schott. School Board Members, Mr. Corey Wade, Mr. Brian Johnson, Mr. Tim Campbell, and Mr. Scott Nation. Condon School District Principal and Superintendent, Mrs. Michelle Keir. Condon School District Vice Principal, Mr. Terry Humphrey. Thank you.
New members of the Lovina S. Palmer Honor Society who performed the induction. The following students have been selected for membership in Honor Society and are asked that they come up to the stage as the name is called. Megan Ahmed.
Membership in the Lovina S. Palmer Honor Society has been earned through the effective demonstration of the four qualities held in high esteem by the Society. Those qualities are scholarship, service, leadership, and character. Our members will describe each of those qualities.
Scholarship means a commitment to learning. A student is willing to spend hours in reading and study, knowing the lasting benefits of a cultivated mind. We should continue to learn even when formal education has ended, for education ends only with life. Knowledge is one great element in life, which leads to the highest success, and it can be acquired in only one way, through diligence and efforts. Learning furnishes the lamp by which we read the past, and the light which illuminates the future. Candidates have the charge to continually expand their world through opportunities inherent in scholarship. Next, we have the quality of service.
Service can be described in various ways. In the routine of the day's work, many opportunities arise to help others. Willingness to work for the benefit of those in need without monetary compensation or recognition is the quality we seek in our membership. We are committed to the ideals of volunteering our time and abilities to the creation of a better tomorrow. Our third quality is leadership.
Leadership should exert a wholesome influence in the school. In taking the initiative in class and school activities, the real leader strives to obtain and encourage others to obtain the same objective. A leader has self-confidence and will go forward when others hesitate.
Not only can I respect myself, nor hope to attain the respect of others. It is this lost character which guides me out through life and I must love to grow soul, said it. Character is achieved in that pursuit. It is the product of constant action, daily striving to make one. The problem of character is the problem of self-control. We must be, in reality, what we wish to appear as. By demonstrating such qualities such as reliability, honesty, and sincerity, we hope to prove by example that we love character.
Please raise your right hand and repeat the following prayer. I pledge myself, always to seek the light of truth, to hold scholarly habits, to actively engage in work service, and to lead forward in all things that shall advance the world of the school.
Please accept the membership certificate of our congratulations. We welcome you and join us in the Lovina S. Palmer Honor Society.
Plays a key role in students' life. Many of us take for granted how much time, effort, and patience it takes to prepare a young person to enter the adult world. The following staff members are an essential part of our school. Would they please rise when their names are called in order to be recognized? Mrs. Lori Myers has been the deputy clerk for the Condon School District for 24 years. Mrs. Tiffany Ariano teaches special education and is in her sixth year at the Condon School District. Mrs. Teresa Jameson has been a cook for the Condon School District for 32 years and will be going to enjoy retirement after this year. Mrs. Katie Hams is in her fifth year as a school-based counselor for the Condon School District. And Mr. Brad Shannon is in his second year working as a district maintenance person and will be going to enjoy retirement after this year. We will now introduce those teachers and staff who are essential parts to students' education and student growth. They will be presenting student awards. When their names are called, will they please make their way to the stage to recognize the students?
Mrs. Heather Devine is in her eighth year teaching at Condon High School. She teaches Algebra 1 and 2, Geometry, College Math, Transition Math, and Personal Finance. She will also be going to enjoy retirement after this year.
I appreciate the opportunity to recognize students that have distinguished themselves in my class. First, I would like to recognize two students that have shown incredible perseverance and growth over this year. They come in early every morning and they work hard every day. The award for perseverance and personal growth go to Junior Calvin Wilkins. And the Excellence in Mathematics Award for the freshman algebra class goes to a student that does quality work and she brings her strong work ethic to class each day. She is always willing and helpful as a peer tutor, and that's Teresa Campbell. I'm a sophomore in geometry class. I'd like to recognize a self-driven, confident student. He pushes himself towards mastery And his brother only has the highest score in the class, but he's maintaining his personal challenge by working several chapters ahead, and that's Christian Takami. And from the junior class, there's also a student that likes to set personal challenges. And last year, she completed geometry in the first semester, and she went on to complete the Algebra 2 course in the second semester, even with the added complication of the pandemic. So this year, she was in our college class, so she's completed 10 credit hours of dual credit college level math, and the junior Essence in Mathematics goes to Kirsten Smith. Recognize the seniors that have earned the Excellence in Mathematics Awards for completing their 10 credit hours of the dual credit college math course. And that's Sydney Gear. Josh Jones. Brian Heisley. Quincy LaRue. And Kiara Takami. And an additional thank you to two seniors that were amazing teaching assistants and tutors for the first semester in our algebra class. They not only shared their knowledge, but they were also great examples in the classroom as role models for our freshman students. So thank you to Riley. And thank you to Josh.
Mr. James Popchak is in his first year teaching at Condon High School. He teaches patterns biology, patterns physics, patterns chemistry, Spanish 1, and workshop.
Although my introduction was fairly informative, I'm actually that line judge guy. First award is for patterns biology. I started the year with a rather interesting activity. I said, okay, I want everybody to put your arms up. Bring them around a little more like that. They were all brought their arms up. And I said, excellent. You guys have made awesome tree huggers. And the arms immediately went down. This individual scholar went on that day. And I'm giving the award to this individual because the answers given are the questions. They're correct. And there are those answers that are incredibly insightful in the concept behind the question. This person consistently gives that style of answer that shows a deep, deep understanding of the concept behind the question. The award for patterns biology, excellence in patterns biology, goes to Kirsten Smith. Chemistry. The seniors this year took an additional year of chemistry. They did patterns chemistry last year, but Rob basically in the quarter due to an activity that, as you guys stressed earlier, they were last, or 2 years ago, I guess now. At any rate, there were two individuals in this particular class that ran neck and neck all year. They would retake tests even when they had done well on them because they figured they could do better with the second attempt. And they had the same percentage in the class. I didn't go down to the tenths and look. But the excellence in chemistry goes to two seniors. Those seniors are Ryland and Cash.
Thank you.
The next one is wood shop. I was thinking of giving an award that I used to give years ago when I bought a fossil, and I can't anymore. I was talking to Mr. Day, and he said, you made yourself. I used to give the Tim Taylor Award. Yeah, the audience is old enough to appreciate it, but the student body is not. So I'm not going to give that award. But I did it once too, and they consistently put out high-quality projects, projects that were very different from each other, and expanded their skills in the area of woodwork. That individual also put out a large number of products and was an excellent self-starter. In woodshop, the basic rule is work as if you were being paid, and I would gladly pay this individual. Excellence in woodshop goes to McKinsey. Amit. Thank you.
Mrs. Stevens is in her fourth year at Condon High School. She teaches English to all grades and yearbook. She also teaches English and history to 7th grade. The opportunity to do this recognition reception. So I'm going to go ahead and take a moment to recognize the young man that is a senior this year, but was a junior in my English class last year, and tried as hard as I could. I couldn't find anything wrong with his papers. He wrote so well that he just blew me out of the water with every single one of them. So a certificate of achievement in English language arts goes to Cash Holmes. I also have three more students for English Language Arts. I recognized my freshman earlier today by giving her award, but that award went to Teresa Campbell. And my yearbook award went to Adeline Drew. In my junior and senior English Language Arts class, they made it hard for me because these three had a tie going almost all year, and there wasn't an extra credit assignment that I put out that the three of them, who didn't need the extra credit, didn't take and do with excellence like everything else. So the first English Language Arts Certificate of Achievement goes to Megan Hallman. And the second goes to Mackenzie Allman. And lastly, to Kirsten Smith. Mr. James Andrews is in his second year of teaching at Condon High School. He teaches world geography, U.S. history, government, economics, music, fifth and sixth grade social studies. He also oversees work experience students.
Good evening, everyone. I have three awards. Present tonight. This first one goes for distinguished achievement in our U.S. history class with the 11th graders. There were a lot of great students in that class this year, but I would like to give the award to Mackenzie Ott. Mackenzie has been remarkably consistent with virtually every short answer question, essay, presentation. She's been willing to think very deeply about our history, and what impresses me the most is Mackenzie, in his writing, demonstrates this willingness to engage with points of view that he doesn't necessarily agree with, to understand why people might think that way, and ultimately I think he's understanding what he believes, and I really appreciate that. Okay, next is the award for distinguished achievement in economics and government, which this is going to go to Kenzie LaRue. Kenzie, I appreciate that our class, your research presentations and questions were very incisive and really deepened my own understanding of economics. Because you have a real knack for asking big questions about something very specific that would make me think a bigger picture about the topic, and I think it really helps everybody else learn. Okay, lastly, I also teach music here, and this is award winning for Musician of the Year. This was a tough choice. There are a lot of really strong players in our music class this year. But this goes to Kirsten Smith. In our first term, Kirsten was a remarkably consistent drummer whose high-level performance came from diligently writing out your drum parts, studying YouTube videos to practice techniques of other drummers. And what really impressed me is in the second semester, she wanted to learn more instruments. She expanded to the piano. Really took to that, sang harmonies, confronted a fear, and sang some weak vocals. So I appreciate that. Thank you.
Mr. Levi Day is in his third year teaching at Condon High School. He teaches health, weights, and PE. He also supervises the college class students and serves as the dean of students.
I am a true believer in the sentiment that iron sharpens iron, that together we all grow stronger. This strength is not limited to physical expression, but also to mental toughness. Grit and perseverance are attributes that will serve each and every one of my students for the rest of their lives. I don't think of the weights last year as a program, as a mere PE credit. It's a community. It's a community that supports, inspires, suffers, and endures each and every day, all in the name of becoming the very best versions of ourselves that we can possibly be. I want to recognize all of the students who willingly opt to be part of this community and do hard things every day. Will each of you that have my class now please stand? The first group of students that I would like to bring up front and recognize have produced enough blood, sweat, and tears in that weight room to float a small ship without question. They've been part of this community every semester since its inception 3 years ago. This group of young men and women embody all that our community stands for. Sydney Gear, May Ahmed, Eddie Barrera, Braden Carmine, Callum Wilkins, and Katie Nation, please come on the stage.
Thank you.
The next award that I want to present is for the most improved. These students have shown remarkable growth in their fitness, their mental toughness, and worked to overcome extreme biomechanical challenges. This group of students are in the constant pursuit of growth, and they always want to know how to be better every single day. I have a quote on my board that I believe sums up this group really well. All of my successes have come from doing the little things each and every day that others could, but choose not to. Will Cash Helms, Ryan Isley, and Cal Wilkins, please come on stage. The next award I want to present is one I call the Grit Award. It's one that's near and dear to my heart for sure. It holds a special place in my heart. There's nothing I value more than seeing Grit demonstrated. It's truly inspiring each and every one of us. These two individuals show up and give their guts every single day. Braden Carnine and Megan Allman, please come to stage. Well, I know we're up here, and I wanted to talk a little bit about Megan. She's worked to become a true student of all things in the weight room. She's dedicated to becoming better in every aspect of her game. I continually push Megan, sometimes maybe to the point of breaking, and she always steps up to the challenge. We often talk about learning to become comfortable being uncomfortable, and she embodies this to the nth degree. She pushes incredibly hard and is very, very, does a great job of becoming very uncomfortable and being comfortable doing it. Thank you, Megan. The last award I have to present is called the Spirit of the Gym Award. For me, this award goes to the person who embodies our entire culture. This young man works extremely hard. He strives for improvement. He demands respect from all students towards their peers, staff. He shows leadership and continually shows that it's not about me in his attitude. I can't count the number of times I've seen this young man gasping for air at the end of a workout, laying on the floor in puddles of sweat, barely having the energy to speak, and yet he finds a way to cheer on his teammates or the people within our class. It is a great honor for me to present Eddie Barrera with the Spirit of the Gym.
Mrs. Michelle Beard is in her 10th year with Condon High School. During that time, she has acted as the high school's principal, counselor, and supervised the early college program students, and is currently our principal and superintendent.
I thought he was messing with me again today, and you'll have to ask the seniors about how they started their day here in the high school. So, okay, I want to take this opportunity to acknowledge all the early college students that have been in the college program for the last 1 or 2 years. These are students that are taking both high school and college level courses through Columbia Gorge Community College. These students have not only received college-level credit, but have done it while being a full-time high school student who also has been participating in extracurricular activities, so that's no easy feat. Would the following students please come forward to receive your Certificate of Excellence for earning credits through early college program. Sydney Garrett. Alyssa Greenwood. Yeah.
comes. Rylan Isley.
Started a legacy award in honor of Ron Cupp's dedication to our students, staff, parents, and community. This plaque hangs in the school and represents those staff members and community members that go beyond the call of duty to provide opportunity to students. The nominations for this award not only represent a great educator, but they are also someone who has volunteered countless hours to the district. This year, we have two recipients that we would like to honor that have tried to retire a couple of times, but we continue to talk them into coming back and filling positions for us in the district. Along with their years of service in teaching and subbing, they have taken on many additional duties, like working in concessions, volunteering to take money at gates, organizing fundraisers, helping at home track meets, coordinating community service projects, and the list of academic student supports could go on and on and on. One of these recipients in particular has many years dedicated to coaching grade school and high school basketball. These are just some of the things that these two educators have done to support students in our school community. It's my honor to present the 2021 Service to Education Award to Carol Harrison and Teresa Humphrey. In our program, when we will introduce to you the members of this year's graduating class. As each senior's name is read, will they please come forward and take their seat in front of the stage? Sydney Gear. Throughout her years at Condon High School, Sydney has been involved in basketball, volleyball, track, tennis, honor society, and leadership. After graduation, Sydney plans on attending Eastern Oregon University to study physical therapy or athletic training. In 10 years, Sydney sees herself finishing grad school and either getting her doctorate in physical therapy or working at a college as an athletic trainer. Thank you, Gilbert. Davey's year at Condon High School, he has been involved in yearbook and text. After graduation, Davey plans to relocate to the Pacific Northwest with his best friend. He also plans on getting his plumbing license and pursuing a career in voice acting. In 10 years, Davey hopes to be succeeding in voice acting while finishing up a plumbing apprenticeship to become a licensed plumber. and he also hopes to be living with the love of his life. Alyssa Greenwood. Throughout high school, Alyssa has been involved in high school rodeo, basketball, track, cross country, volleyball, and leadership. After graduation, Alyssa plans to attend Boise State University, where she will major in biology. After receiving her undergraduate degree, Alyssa plans to transfer to another university to receive her degree in veterinary medicine. In 10 years, Alyssa sees herself still studying away in veterinary school, working towards her goal of becoming an equine veterinarian. In his years of high school, Cassius participated in basketball, men's volleyball, tennis, honor society, and leadership. After graduation, Cash plans to attend Eastern Oregon University with an undecided major. In 10 years, Cash sees himself making boatloads of money at a job he loves. Riley Isaac. Throughout high school, Ryland has been involved in honor society, leadership club, basketball, track, men's volleyball, and tennis. After graduation, Ryland will attend Oregon State University studying kinesiology and hopes to land a job in the athletic field. In 10 years, Ryland sees himself located somewhere in the United States with a good job in athletics. He would like to have a nice house near many outdoor activities. He may possibly have a family, he might not. He will see how things turn out. Mackenzie has participated in volleyball, track and field, and leadership, along with volunteering her time to gather food for our local food pantry. After graduation, Mackenzie plans to attend the University of Oregon to study writing, art, and business. In 10 years, Mackenzie sees herself using the skills she learned in college to create and contribute to the making of animated movies and TV shows.
Katie Nation. Throughout high school, Katie has been involved in volleyball, basketball, track and field, honor society, leadership, and student government. After graduation, Katie plans on attending Eastern Oregon University to study biology and pre-medical sciences. Eventually, she plans to transfer to a bigger university to get her MD, PhD. In 10 years, Katie sees herself still in school, working through the introductory years of her residency and enjoying every moment. Francisco Sanchez. Throughout Francisco's year at Condon High School, he has participated in football, baseball, and music. After graduation, Francisco is planning to attend Eastern Washington University to major in business. In 10 years, Francisco sees himself running his own business and having a house, a family, and helping his friends and family in ways he has not been able to do before. Dakota Smith. Throughout her years in high school, Dakota Smith has participated in volleyball, track, leadership, volunteer firefighting, 4-H swine, and young life. After graduation, Dakota plans on attending a free online college program through Eastern Gateway Community College to study mental health. She is also planning to move to a larger area with more opportunities. In 10 years, Dakota wants to be a mental health counselor with a beautiful place to live and enjoy life. Kiara Zimbabwe. Throughout high school, Kiara has been involved in student government, honor society, emergency medical responding, volleyball, basketball, track, and yoga. After graduation, Kiara plans to go to Lincoln University to major in performing arts, mathematics, and computer science, and a minor in music. In 10 years, Kiara sees herself pursuing professions she loves. Although she hasn't decided whether that's acting or cryptanalysis, she also sees herself starting a family by this time. Emma Wood. Throughout high school, Emma has participated in 2 years of volleyball, volunteered her time as a secretary in leadership, gathered food for the local food pantry, and Young Life Clubs. After graduation, Emma plans on attending Central Oregon Community College and eventually transferring to a university to get her degree in pharmaceuticals. In 10 years, Emma hopes to achieve a debt-free life and working her dream job as a pharmacist and living her best life.
I would now like to introduce Mrs. Katie Hams, who will begin our presentation of scholarships. The first scholarship is the Old School Scholarship. Sydney Gear will receive a scholarship in the amount of $900. Alyssa Greenwood will receive a scholarship in the amount of $900. Cash Helms will receive a scholarship in the amount of $900. Rylan Isley will receive a scholarship in the amount of $900. Caitlin Nation will receive a scholarship in the amount of $900. Emma Weddle will receive a scholarship in the amount of $900. The next scholarship is the UP's Most Valuable Scholarship. Caitlin Nation will receive a scholarship in the amount of $750. And the Condon Scholarship will also go to Ryan Newley in the amount of $750. The next scholarship is the Mid-Columbia Bus Scholarship. The recipient is Sydney Gear in the amount of $500. Our next scholarship is the Red Cross Scholarship, and Caitlin Nation will get this in the amount of $500. Announced tonight is the Penny Gronka Scholarship, and this award is $500, and it goes to Caitlin Nation and Cash Helms. I would also like to take this time to recognize some of the seniors for scholarships they've already received. So please stand when your name is called. Sydney Gear. Sydney was awarded the Eastern Oregon University Scholar Award in the amount of $1,000 a year for 4 years. Alyssa Greenwood. Alyssa has been awarded the Western Undergraduate Exchange Scholarship to cover out-of-state tuition. Cash Helms. Cash has been awarded the Eastern Oregon University Scholar Award in the amount of $1,000 a year for 4 years. Rylan Icy. Rylan has been awarded the Finley Academic Scholarship in the amount of $5,000 for 4 years, and the Ford Foundation Scholarship, which pays up to 90% of unpaid tuition. Caitlin Mission. Caitlin has been awarded the Eastern Oregon University Scholar Award in the amount of $1,000 a year for 4 years. Mackenzie LaRue. Mackenzie has been awarded the Pathway Oregon program that covers tuition costs at the University of Oregon and the APAC scholarship in the amount of $2,000 a year for 4 years. Kiara Tukagi. Kiara has been awarded the Music Achievement Award from Linfield University in the amount of $5,000 a year for 4 years. She's also been awarded the Francis R. Linfield Scholarship in the amount of $21,500 per year for 4 years, and the Linfield University Grant in the amount of $10,000 per year for 4 years. There are still many scholarships that have later deadlines, as well as scholarship committees who are meeting later this summer. So those awards will be announced personally to each student later this summer. So students, please keep checking your emails and your phone messages. I have had the privilege of working individually and in groups with the seniors, and I just want to congratulate all the seniors on their scholarship accomplishments, as they have worked extremely hard this year. Congratulations. I would now like to call up Laura Carson and Dorothy Schott to present Condon Scholarship Foundation.
Thank you, everybody who has contributed to Condon Bowlers, well, Condon Scholarship Foundation, used to be Condon Bowlers or Scholars. And I'd like to thank each of the seniors who have applied for this scholarship or have given to you. In order to save a little time in this heat, I'm going to ask all the seniors to come up at once and I'll tell you when. All the names of the scholarships. That they all received. All nine who applied for the scholarship received $2,700 from Condon Scholarship Foundation. And the Oregon Community Foundation holds some of our scholarship money, and each year it varies a little bit. But this year, the Don and Zola Dunbar and Lowe scholarships, each senior will receive $775 from the Dunbar and Lowe scholarship. From the Roy and Missy Evans scholarship, eight will receive that. Emma, Katie, Kiera, Sydney, Alyssa, Mackenzie, Ryland, and Cash. And then all will receive a waste management scholarship that I don't know where they don't have that scholarship yet, but all will receive that. Now, I'd like you to all come up because there are a few special scholarships to be given out also. Besides those mentioned, these are the specific individual scholarships. Francisco received $300 from Elite Clean Energy. In addition, Emma Webb received $300 words from the Kennedy Barnett Memorial. In addition, PD Nation receives $500 from Condon Chamber of Commerce. Cass Shields receives $300 from the Zane Campbell Memorial. Ryan Isley receives $500 from the John Glory and Dorothy Tierney Memorial Scholarship. Mackenzie LaRue receives an addition a $400 scholarship from Dr. Flora Fenimore. Alyssa Greenwood receives the Jack and Connie Fatman Memorial Scholarship for $500. Sydney Gear receives the Bill and Annabelle Yeager Memorial Scholarship for $300. And Kiara receives a $300 scholarship from the P. Pryor Memorial Fund. Thank you.
I would now like to call Mrs. Coplick and Mrs. Hinton to the stage to present.
Good evening. I would like to recognize two students who were outstanding last year in the health services program. At the time, we didn't know that would be the final year of that program, and with the pandemic, we weren't allowed to recognize them last year. But they were tremendous academic students and finished a very difficult class under some extreme circumstances where we couldn't meet in person to practice skills, etc. So I'd like to recognize Sydney Gear and Kiara Tripagi as students of the month. I'm in sort of the same situation that Mrs. Hinton was in with our wildland class last year. That was the last one I understand that we taught here. And I would like to recognize two students who suffered through with online teaching and finishing their hands-on day, Dakota Smith and Kirsten Smith. As an added bonus for the fire department, Dakota has actually joined the fire department and she will be able to fight fire with her sister. For quite a number of years, the Southfield County Ambulance has offered a scholarship to the EMR students or student who has completed their EMR class and then comes and provides service with us. This year, we're offering a $600 scholarship to Kiara Tsukami. Kiara has spent numerous hours on the ambulance with us, and we certainly appreciate it.
Is there anyone else who has a scholarship to announce? At this time, each of the seniors would like to honor those people who have helped them reach this point in their lives.
Oh, I'm not good, but Thank you. Thank you to all the individuals who helped make tonight possible. Please join me in giving them a round of applause for all their support.
Just one more thing before I let you all go. Will Mrs. Devine come to the stage, please? We greatly appreciate all your support and encouragement through the years. We want to present you with a Certificate of Excellence for being an outstanding teacher. Thank you for being you. Thank you for helping us to celebrate our accomplishments this evening. We will keep everyone posted on graduation details. Have a great evening.
Thank you.